Coming up, insights about hand tool dangers and productivity that every contractor should know. Hello and welcome to this week's Primed Insight. My name is Steven. I'm a manager here at BlastOne. Commercial contractors understand that total surface preparation is typically divided between two processes, blasting and hand tooling, the majority being handled through blasting. But we all know the hardest work involves using hand tools to clean the surface. Today we're going to discuss two components of hand tools, worker safety and productivity. First, let's address a reality that it's either a low priority or no priority in comparison to all the other dangers present on a job site. But it's a danger nonetheless, and that's the danger of prolonged exposure to vibration. There are two categories regarding exposure to vibration. The first is known as whole body, which, as its name indicates, involves vibrational impact to the worker's entire body. You can think of activities such as operating a jackhammer or riding in an off-road vehicle as creating whole body vibrational impacts. The other classification is known as hand and arm vibration, which are delivered by using hand tools or even a lawnmower. HAVS is an acronym which stands for hand-arm vibration syndrome. And it encompasses a group of symptoms caused by damage from the use of vibrating tools. Some of these symptoms include decreased grip strength, decreased hand sensation and dexterity, finger blanching or white fingers, and carpal tunnel syndrome. Now, according to an article on safetyandhealthmagazine.com, about 2 million US workers are exposed to hand-arm vibration, and as many as half will develop HAVS. Now, some experts believe the number may be higher because the disorder is sometimes unrecognized or underreported. Now, global estimates vary, but potentially tens of millions of workers are exposed to high levels of vibration in the workplace. Donald Peterson, joint professor of biomedical engineering at Texas A&M University, is quoted as saying, "I'd go as far to say it's probably the number one neuromuscular disorder in the world in manufacturing and construction environments, the most costly and underappreciated." Now, if so many workers suffer from HAVS, why then is this not a big industry topic? Well, unfortunately, perhaps the main reason is because here in the United States, OSHA has not yet established any standards regarding exposure limits to vibration for either whole body or hand and arm. Now, in Australia, OSHA has set standards for whole body, but not hand and arm. This is the case even though both ANSI and the EU share an exposure limit for both categories. And if you're thinking, well, the government knows best, consider the fact that at one time, governments didn't outlaw silica either. Just because it's not mandated yet doesn't mean you should look the other way when it comes to your employees or your own health and safety. As a matter of fact, according to NIOSH biomechanical engineer Daniel Welcome, hand-arm vibration syndrome can take 6 months to 6 years to develop, and after the fingers blanch, the condition is irreversible. Friends, don't wait for the government. The evidence is available if you Google it. Protect yourself, and we're going to tell you how. Here is a list of solutions that can help, and we've decided to list them in order of least productive to most productive. Number one, limit operating time for hand tools. Less time working with hand tools is obviously good for the worker, but not for the project. Now, this is an option, but not the most productive. Number two, use protective gloves that absorb the vibration. However, there are a few problems with anti-vibration gloves you should know about. First, NIOSH study tested four types of gloves and found the gloves lowered vibration to the palms by 15 to 20% while operators used medium to high frequency tools, but only slightly lowered or even sometimes slightly increased the vibration when using low frequency tools. Workers receive little benefit from anti-vibrational gloves for frequencies under 25 hertz. Also, many workers do not like full finger gloves because they don't provide enough tactile feedback or gripping adhesion to the tool. So some workers cut the fingertips off. Advice, if you're using anti-vibration gloves, do not cut the fingertips off. Number three is to rotate workers, dividing the hand tooling surface area among many individuals. However, like solution number one, this negatively affects efficiency, consistency, and productivity. It's a better solution than number one, but it's just not the best. And number four, the absolute best solution to decrease your chances of developing HAVS is to purchase specially engineered tools that minimize overall vibration. And in our opinion, the superior hand tools you should purchase are the Trelawney VL Needle Scalers or VL Chisel Scalers. The VL stands for VibroLow. Trelawney engineered these tools to have the lowest vibrational impact to your hands and arms. First, let's visibly show you a comparison, something you can compare with your eyes. This is called the Cornflower Test. You're going to see a bowl of watered-down cornflour attached to the top of two different needle scalers. Watch the vibrational difference. The first is a standard needle scaler. The second is a VibroLow needle scaler. The second way we'd like to prove how amazing the Trelawney VL needle scalers are is by comparing the vibrational intensity readouts of the two scalers just shown. Since our industry is unfamiliar with this whole concept, it might first help to give a quick table showing what is safe and what isn't. Vibrational magnitude is measured in meters per second squared. Here is a table depicting the safe recommendations from both ANSI and the European Union that show you how long it's safe to operate at various vibrational intensities. Let's see what reading a standard needle scaler provides the measuring instrument. The readout fluctuates between 19.2 and 19.4, so let's average that at 19.3. So what is the maximum limit of exposure for a vibration level of 19.3? ANSI recommends no longer than 32 minutes per day at this level. So if you care about yourself or your workforce, exposure to this level of intensity should not exceed 32 minutes in any single workday. Now let's test the Trelawney LV needle scaler. This maxed out at 2.76, so let's just go ahead and use its high point as the intensity and take a look at the recommended daily maximum exposure to this vibrational force. As you can see, it exceeds a full day. This vibration equals 32 minutes maximum. This vibration is safe for an entire 24 hours. So I know what you might be thinking. You're thinking, sure, a low vibrational tool is safe, but it's probably gonna take me a full 24 hours to accomplish what I can do in 30 minutes with a standard needle scaler. Low vibration means low productivity, right? Well, let's show you a side-by-side speed test and find out. Actually, the LV needle scaler was 43% faster. Safer and faster is what we call superior equipment. If you're interested in where you can get one of those vibrational testing instruments, as well as the calculating spreadsheet, we'll leave you links below. This is serious stuff, and we want you to have the information. That being said, please feel free to reach out to BlastOne to further discuss the line of Trelawney low vibrational scalers, and let's make sure all your hand tools are optimized for both safety and productivity. Thanks for watching this week's Primed Insight. We'll see you next week.